Hello, welcome to another edition of Back in Shape with T. I'm Tarashe, and today we're going to explore a workout with the Total Gym doing lat pullovers. One of my favorite exercises to work the latissimus dorsi, that's why it's called the lats pullover, and it also gets the abdominals and pecs involved. I'm going to make the abdominals get involved a little bit more with this first exercise because I'm going to do a crunch with it. So if you're able to do this, I want you to come along with me. I'm going to try to do anywhere from 10 to 15 repetitions. So lying down here, stretch those arms back, crunch up, one. Get the stretch and the crunch, two. Three. Four, stretching, five. When I stretch, I'm really thinking about the upper body, the intercostals, and the lats. That's part. The pecs are getting involved just a bit. When I stretch back here and I pull over mid-chest right here, that's when I get most pec involvement. And then up. Reach back and pause it, and crunch. Let's do 5 more. One, stretch, two, three, four, five, and stretch. Feel that stretch for a couple of seconds, and then take a quick break. All right, the next set that I do on this, I'm not gonna do any crunches at all. I'm gonna go straight up lat pullover, and I'm gonna do 15. So if you're gonna do this along with me, try your best to do 15. If you can't, let me give you a better range. 8 to 15 reps would be good. Remember, I have this on the highest incline, which is 6. On this particular apparatus, you may need to bring it lower to make this work for you. All right, let's get set for set number 2. No crunch. One, stretch. Two, stretch it back. Three, four, five. I'm getting fatigued here. Six, feel that stretch. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, my pecs are on fire, and triceps a bit, 13, 14, suck the stomach in tight, 15, my pecs are on fire. It is what it is, man. The pecs actually do work when you're doing a lat pullover. I'm not gonna be able to get 15 anymore. I'm gonna go for sets of 10 to finish this off with. The lat pullovers are great exercises to add as an adjunct to your pull-ups, your seated rows. I'm gonna do a video where I add in one-arm dumbbell rows. I'll probably do seated rows, pull-ups, and lat pullovers to show you how to do a comprehensive back workout for the upper portion, upper and mid portion of the back using the Total Gym and dumbbell apparatus. Something you could do quick and simple at home. If you choose to do so, you will get a really holistic, well-rounded upper mid back workout. The reason why I don't say lower back is because we would actually have to do something else to hit the lower back more directly than those exercises that I rattled off. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna do 10, man. I am seriously, I am really experiencing muscle fatigue. Here we go. One. Two, come on with me, stretch. Three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now I'm feeling it in the triceps. 9, 10. The triceps act as a great stabilizer when you're doing this exercise. So it is getting some involvement. It's not a direct tricep exercise. It's not a substitute for doing triceps, but there is some involvement like we get when we do the ab roller. And speaking of ab roller, I think we're gonna finish this routine off with a couple of sets of ab roller after I do my last set of lat pullover here. I love the ab roller too. It's a simple little apparatus that you can get, order it. Try to get the one with the two wheels. The one with the one wheel is a little bit more advanced. The one with the two wheel is obviously more stable. It's more stability on the ground. The smaller the contact space with the ground is, the harder it is to balance yourself. So you don't want to have to balance yourself too much on the ab roller. All right, here we go. Let's do 11, just for fun. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, pull over, stretch, 6, 7, 8, 9, straight arms, 10, you have to feel it to believe it, 11, all right, good. From there, I'm gonna hold this down, and then we're gonna do some leg lifts. 1, 2, slowly on the way down. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, slowly on the way down. 9, and 10. Oh, oh my goodness. Pretty damn exhausting. All right, next exercise, I'm gonna grab the ab wheel and we're gonna do some rollouts on the floor. All right, I hope you have an ab wheel. We're gonna do 2 sets. I'm gonna try 15 repetitions on each. Abs pulled in tight, tuck the belly button in toward the spine. Go down, stretch. 2, feel that stretch. 3, one of the best ab exercises you can do. 4, do not look up like this. Keep your eyes on the ground. 5, neck as long as possible. 6, 7, stretch. 8, stretch. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, one more, 15. This is absolutely one of the best exercises you can do for your abdominals. Try to keep your back as straight as possible. There should be natural lordosis or natural curvature, but no excess curvature to the back. Some people will not be strong enough to do this, but if you are a person who has the base strength to do this, this particular exercise is a nice adjunct to the lat pullovers. Although we're not hitting the arms and triceps directly, it's a great way to strengthen those triceps as stabilizers when we're doing both open and closed chain exercises. Okay, so I won't have to do pull-ups today. My my triceps are on fire. Scoop the belly button in toward the spine. Let's focus on our Pilates breathing. That means exhale, and suck the stomach in. All right, as you suck that, as you exhale, you suck the stomach in, blow through a straw, pull the belly button toward your spine. Here we go. One. Two. And feel that stretch. Three. Stretch. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. This helps to strengthen your wrist too. 10. Abs tight, suck it in. 13. 14. Feel that stretch through the core. 15. And there you have it. That's our little workout for today. Lat pullover with the Total Gym. Simple ab wheel rollout. A great combination. Very simple workout, especially on your days off, right? So this would be what I would consider an active rest day. So give it a try. I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.